Somewhere in Southeast Asia, the Prime Minister is in a meeting with a diplomat. Moments later, gunshots are heard. A security agent runs toward the sound and sees both the Prime Minister and diplomat dead, murdered by a group of rebels. The man encounters the rebels, but he realizes that he is outnumbered. Then he grabs a dagger and slashes his own throat. 17 hours earlier, Jack Dwyer is taking his wife Annie and daughters Lucy and Bees on a trip to the same Southeast Asian location, where he will start working for a new company called Cardiff. On the plane, the family meets a man called Hammond. Bees asks him about the scars on his hand and face. He claims they came from a tiger fight in which he pulled out the tiger's tooth and from falling down the stairs respectively. Once everyone gets there, Hammond offers to share a ride with them, provided by his friend Kenny Roger, which he says is his nickname because he looks like the singer. The family make it to their hotel. Jack finds Annie crying in her room, unhappy about uprooting their lives here. He tries to turn on the TV, but learns from the clerk downstairs that all the cable and internet across the city is down. The next morning, Jack tries to get a newspaper, and the clerk tells him to go to a nearby store to find a newspaper. Jack walks to the store, and the clerk there sells him an American paper from 3 days ago. When Jack walks outside, he sees a huge mob of armed civilians walking toward an equally large group of police in riot gear. One civilian throws a rock, and the cops start shooting at them. Jack is caught in the middle of the chaos and runs toward safety. Everywhere he runs, he finds rebels killing innocent people. He runs back to the hotel and sees the rebels taking a man that also works for Cardiff, and they execute him. Jack is spotted until he climbs up a fire escape and evades the rebels. He runs back to the hotel and sees the rebels have started breaking in and are killing the staff and other guests. He runs back to his room to get Annie and the girls, but Annie says that Lucy went to the pool. Jack runs to get her while Annie stays in the room with Bees. The rebels are knocking down doors and storming into rooms to kill foreigners. Annie holds the door back while telling Bees to stay hidden. Meanwhile, Jack finds Lucy and grabs her just as the rebels start running into the place. Jack runs back toward the room and is almost attacked by a rebel until Hammond comes in at the right moment to kill him, and he tells Jack to take his family to the roof. Jack gets Annie and the girls up to the roof, where other foreigners are gathered. Outside the hotel, the rebels are chanting blood for water, due to Cardiff taking over the water supply, leading to the military coup. A helicopter then flies up over the roof, making everyone think that they're being rescued. Unfortunately, the helicopter is carrying more rebels. Jack and Annie grab their girls and run as one rebel opens fire on the foreigners. As they run for cover, the helicopter gets tangled in some wires and is pulled to the roof, causing it to explode. The other rebels start to make their way up to the roof and kill anyone in their path. Jack tells Annie they need to get to the roof of the next building, which means making a huge leap. Annie hesitates, but she runs over and falls on the roof, scraping her knees and elbows. Jack throws Bees without warning, but Annie catches her. He is about to throw Lucy next, but she stops him mid-toss and nearly causes both her and Jack to fall over the building until he pulls her up. Lucy gets thrown and Annie catches her, and then Jack makes his leap. They get inside the building, but the rebels start attacking it with a tank. Jack gets his family hidden as the rebels continue killing people. He assures the girls that he loves them. A rebel walks into the room as it's become quiet. He spots Jack and starts to call to his comrades, but Jack tackles him and tries to keep him quiet, but the rebel continues to shout, leaving Jack with no choice but to bludgeon the man to death. The family disguises themselves and makes their way toward the American embassy while trying to remain undetected. They ride past a mob of rebels and get knocked down, but still manage to ride on safely. They reach the embassy, which has a blockade on both sides. Jack climbs over and sees all the Americans dead. The rebels run out of the embassy as it explodes, and Jack runs back to his family. The family searches for shelter in a Buddhist shrine after pleading with the caretaker to let them stay, but predictably, the rebels show up. They kick the caretaker around and then try to find the family. Jack sees one rebel left his gun unguarded, so he tries to go for it. When it looks like he's about to get caught, Annie stands up and calls attention to herself. The rebel leader punches her until Hammond shows up in the nick of time. He and Kenny kill the rebels except for the leader, who gets away. Hammond takes the family to a secret place. He explains to Jack that the people he works for are responsible for bringing American companies like Cardiff out there. To control the water supply, so Hammond feels he must redeem himself by helping the family. He tells them that they need to take a boat toward the Vietnamese border, where the rebels cannot touch them. As the group makes their way to their destination, more rebels attack from a gun tower nearby. The family gets away, but Kenny is killed. While Hammond shoots and kills most of the rebels, he gets wounded, and he tells Jack to keep going. A rebel comes riding in a truck. Although Hammond is dying, he musters enough strength to shoot the truck, but it plows into him and crashes. The family makes it to the riverbank, where Jack trades his watch and shoes to a fisherman for his boat. More rebels show up and Annie and the girls hide. Jack fights back, but he gets overpowered and is nearly executed, but is just shot in the arm. Lucy runs toward him, and the rebel leader grabs her. He gives her a gun and forces her to shoot her dad, and he holds a gun to her head as an incentive. Annie runs in and whacks the leader over the head and beats him to death. While Jack grabs the gun and kills the rest of the rebels, the family gets on the boat, where Jack and Annie paddle toward the Vietnamese border. The troops spot them and order them to stop, but Jack says he will not and pleads them to let him and his family in. Another group of rebels show up in a truck and drive near the family. Before they can do anything, the boat passes through the border, officially entering Vietnamese territory, and the troops ordered the rebels to stand down. Finally, the family's trouble ended. The family are recovering in a hospital bed together. Lucy asks her parents to tell the story of how she was born. Jack says how he told Annie to push until Lucy came out, but she didn't start breathing when the doctors spanked her. Annie had told Jack to speak to Lucy since she would know his voice. Jack spoke to her until she started breathing, and he then holds his family closely.